Hey golfers, it's Thomas Campbell, Master Club Fitter at Second Swing. Today I'm excited to introduce the new Tour Edge E521 Iron-Woods. So the Iron-Woods quite possibly could be one of the easiest irons you will ever hit. I'm really excited to test this club out. I have the 4-iron here to test out, so I'm going to take a look at some numbers here very, very soon. But first, let's talk about the technology behind this club. So first, there is a Houdini sole around the back and the bottom. So what this does is this reduces the turf interaction up to 35% and dramatically moves the weight deep and low. So this is going to be a very, very high ML iron. It also has hollow body perimeter weighting. So this creates distance properties of a metal wood for a maximum ball speed and distance in an iron. It also has quite a lot of offset. So slice fighting offset design. This works in conjunction with the heel weight close to the face at impact for straighter and more accurate shots. So if you're a player that has a little bit of an issue with a slice, this may be able to help straighten out some of your shots as well. It also has a very super shallow face design. So this will help launch the ball high up in the air with ease and get that ball to go even further. So very excited to test this club out. The golf shafts, we've got the graphite Fubuki golf shaft. This is an extremely light golf shaft. And then in the steel shaft options, we have the KBS Max 80. This club comes from 3-iron all the way up to AW wedge. So the 3-iron's got 20 degrees loft all the way up to the gap wedge, which has 49 degrees loft. So let's hit a few shots, take a look at some numbers, and see how this club performs. Okay, so let's discuss the numbers. So the first thing I do want to touch on is how easy this club is to draw. Every single shot that I hit with this 4-iron wood drew, had a decent amount of curve on it, and we'll touch on those curve numbers here in a little bit too. So take a look at the numbers. So my club speed on average is around about 95 miles an hour. My ball speed was very close to 142. So this is a 4-iron lofted club. It's got 23 degrees of loft on it. And I was generating a smash factor of 1.5. You'll notice shot one, I had a 1.46. I didn't quite catch that one, didn't go quite as far, but it was still very, very forgiving. If we take a look at the other four shots, it was 151 or 150 every single time. So the level of forgiveness in this club is extremely good, very, very good. Not only is it designed to be forgiving, but it's designed to go a lot further and be very, very accurate with the ability to draw the ball a little bit there too. It was in the right spin window as well. It was spinning at about 4,300 RPMs. Now this is a 4-iron/4-wood, so that is ideal for me. Let's take a look at some other numbers here as I zoom across. Okay, so on average, I was carrying the ball about 220 going 232. So I love the fact that it was carrying a little bit further than my traditional 4-iron would. Now, I'm not the type of player that would play this particular club because I don't need help to draw the ball and maybe not as much for regards to forgiveness. But the one thing I want to touch on is the stopping power that you get with this club too. So difference between carry and total right there was about 13 yards, which is pretty good. We take a look at the height. It was flying 107 feet in the air on average with a landing angle of 45 degrees. So very good option to get the ball up in the air, carry a little bit further, and stop on the green for you there as well. Speaking of that curve number, I want to just touch on the curve number here. If you take a look here, you can see curve left every single time. But every single time I was able to get that ball to curve to left. So that was really impressive. On average, had about 51 feet of curve to the left. So definitely a draw bias club. The offset helps. The weight helps a little bit there too. So definitely a slice fighting design. So great club. I'm excited to see how this club tests compared to other models coming out in 2021, but I think it's going to be a great option. So if you haven't already, I highly recommend subscribing to our channel. If you could you give us a like on this button here too? Give us a thumbs up. And then we've got plenty of other content coming your way. Thanks again for watching. Bye.